very warm welcome to this special edition of Rajya Sabha Television. Every year, India's military prowess and cultural heritage is displayed on Republic Day. India is now gearing up to celebrate 71st Republic Day in 2020. But ever imagined how meticulously the entire exercise is planned? In this edition, I'll get you what happens behind the scenes. Come along with me on this journey. Midnight and the drill started with the Mandir Parade, which is a customary practice for all the soldiers of the army. It is called parade because everyone available must attend it and there is no exemption. All officers and jawans are expected to perform as per the religion of the regiment. If a regiment is predominantly Sikh, then all will go for Ardas. And if Hindu, then everyone will perform Aarti. It is a standard practice in the army that all religious places of different religions share the same space. In the Indian army, all religions follow just one faith, that is, service to the nation.
अधर्म का नाश हो
प्राणियों में सद्भावना हो
विश्व का कल्याण हो
भारत पर महान हो
भाई ऑल सेट ठीक ठाक है अभी 30 सेकंड सब अपनी अपनी गाड़ियों में 30 सेकंड गिन रहा हूं मैं मेरे वो गो कहते ही गाड़ियों में गो
There would be massive traffic restrictions in place right now in the central Delhi area because of the movement of these massive tanks showcasing India's military might. It is hard to miss the shine you see on the marching military tanks and meticulously maintained weaponry that rolls out at Rajpath. A special camp is set up at the parade premise for tanks and weapon systems, where they undergo quality checks before making their spectacular stage appearance. The infusion of high technology based precision weaponry has enhanced the lethality of future warfare manifold. The spectrum of threat ranges from the nuclear to the conventional and to asymmetric.
Indicate kar usko.
On the Republic Day, India's military might is on the display. A key aspect of the exercise is to showcase the effectiveness of India's integrated action meant to rapidly thrust into enemy territory with a composite force of infantry, tanks, artillery and fixed as well as rotary aircraft among other military assets. The specific threats India expects in a particular area or the operational goals of the group, India will deploy multiple resources against its foes.
Most important part is to ensure that the vehicles are correctly placed. Once they are correctly placed, then it is not a very difficult job because everything is then planned out in which sequence the vehicles will be moving, how they will be moving, and there are boys from the military police who ensure that these columns move in an organized manner. And we have got cooperation from the Delhi police who help us in the traffic management along with our boys.
Then we moved to the iconic India Gate.
And now we've reached Amar Jawan Jyoti, the eternal flame dedicated to our soldiers. It's already midnight and you can see the movement of tanks all across to be stationed here.
An eternal flame burns at the Amar Jawan Jyoti to commemorate the indomitable courage of our armed forces personnel who have made the supreme sacrifice in the service of the country. For the bigger weaponry and armory, including tanks, there is a special camp set up at India Gate, and each weapon equipment has to undergo a good 10 stages of checks, which includes them being regularly painted too for the final parade. The next day started rather early.
It's midnight and we've reached the Karyappa parade ground. It's extremely cold, it's raining. But let's see how the troops are getting ready for today's drill.
The cold barracks that house the troops turn lively at midnight. Tight corners on the bed, ruthless efficiency, glorious shine. Yes, our men know the value of swachhta. Space is a premium in such places. Everything has a designated space and must be returned to the space when it is no longer needed. So every uniform will have a hanger, every backpack its own hook. Then we move to one of the cook houses.
So there's a bit of respite now from the chilly winds and constant drizzling as you're inside the cook house, where breakfast is being prepared for the troops and that would be served to the troops at Rajpath. It's already 2 a.m. The aroma is tantalizing, and in the breakfast, there's soya bean ki sabzi, paratha, and dalia.
Napoleon did say, an army marches on its stomach. Well, the Indian soldiers come from diverse backgrounds and represent diversity from the regions, states, clans, and tribes. However, the greatest leveler is the food in the langar. A group of jawans temper the food with ghee, tomatoes, onions and chilies for a gastronomical delight. The warmth from the chai is contagious. When men relate to each other and there is a motive that welds them together, the spirit of camaraderie produces a different taste in everything, let alone the food which will be consumed together at India Gate. Then the contingents move from Karyappa Parade Ground to Rajpath. What concludes in a few hours on January 26 takes months of toil and determination. The finesse of the magnificent Republic Day parade that India watches with pride is the result of a lengthy practice session.
बोलिए भारत माता की
जय
रंगबली महाराज की
जय
रंगबली महाराज की
जय
बोलो ऑप्शनल की
जय
Starting at 3 a.m. and dedication of the participating armed forces, paramilitary jawans and other participants and behind the scenes helpers, the laborers, the cleaners, the security staff, among others, who brave the relentless Delhi chill to make the parade a flawless spectacle. And guns. plants go through levels of security screening to ensure that there is no live cockroach. The contingents brave the early morning and late afternoon winter chills and the infamous Delhi fog to walk down Rajpath numerous times a day, and the majestic Rashtrapati Bhavan bears testimony to that fact. The practice never stops. Rain or shine, sick or injured, fog or no visibility, nothing can cause an interruption. The discipline of it is such that it rubs it on all participants. Endurance and patience comes just by watching, by being there, by being a part of all of it. Behind the scenes, there is an enormous amount of waiting, repeating, waiting again, and doing it all over again. Each time you do it over, you have to do it perfectly and as you did it all other times. You have to think that the entire nation is watching you and you are saluting the dignitaries as you go past them. And then there is more practice off-site, before and after the actual practice, physical drills, exercise regime, and a lot more. It could be easy for the people from the armed forces, but for a bunch of school-going girls, this is an endurance test. They prepare you well for 2 hours and perhaps for a lifetime. If the discipline was not to serve, the show would never be so well executed year after year. Dressed impeccably in their uniforms and marching in sync to the leading officer's commands, contingents of Border Security Force, contingents of paramilitary forces, Indian Army, Indian Air Force, Indian Navy, Delhi Police, can be seen rehearsing in the VRs. Patriotic pulse fills the air and adds to the nationalistic vibe. Then comes Captain Tanya Shergill of Corps of Signals. She wears the badge of honour. Breaking the glass ceiling, Captain Tanya Shergill was first woman officer, parade adjutant in the Army Day celebrations for the year 2020. She wears a spectacular look with traditional military regalia and splendour. A fourth generation Army officer, Captain Tanya will lead her contingent on Republic Day as well. The energy of rehearsals is palpable. Low visibility, cold winds or tiresome schedules, nothing deters the spirit of those involved. Of course, there are chai breaks and light and laid-back moments thereafter, but their dedication to the call of duty is salute worthy. The morning star appears, the night gives way, dawn breaks on the world. The drill, however, continues.
इस परेड को 90 मिनट में कोऑर्डिनेट करने के लिए, जैसे कि मैं कल भी बता चुका हूं, आप सब लोगों की कोऑपरेशन जरूरी है. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि कोई भी आप में से इस पूरी चेन का कमजोर कड़ी बने.
The sun shone bright the next day as we started exploring the section of tableau.
And artists are busy preparing the colourful tableaus with social messages exhibiting India's cultural diversity.
A total of 22 tableaus will be showcased in the Republic Day Parade this year. Among these, 16 will be from various states and union territories and 6 of ministries, departments and the National Disaster Response Force.
This time, we are going to display 22 states and union territory, department and ministries apart from MOD tableau.
Jammu and Kashmir will participate in the parade for the first time as a union territory. The state's tableau will showcase the rich sartorial and cultural heritage of the region, with the shawl weaver being depicted in the front. The flora and fauna will be shown in the middle, complemented with the Dogra and Kashmiri folk culture.
Kashmiri geet gyaun bolte hain gyaun rope aur paper mache mein fem
portal nitto ka dress hai ye traditional dress hai traditional dance ka dress hai टोटल हमारे 26 जने हैं और पिछले एक महीने से सब लोग यहाँ पर प्रैक्टिस कर रहे हैं और बहुत मज़े कर रहे हैं. विविधता में एकता का यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं.
इस झांकी में हम पंजाब से 26 मेंबर आए हैं. यहाँ पर झांकी को जो हम गुरु नानक साहब के जो संदेश हैं उनका 550 साल जो प्रकाश पर्व है उसको मनाने जा रहे हैं. और इसमें गुरु नानक साहब ने सांझी बालता सारी दुनिया के लिए संदेश दिया था, किरत करो, नाम जपो और बंड शको का.
NDRF is participating for the first time in the January 26 parade. Cutting-edge technology and instruments used by the NDRF during rescue operations in flooded areas and Delhi's Anaj Mandi Inferno last year will be showcased as part of its tableau. A song extolling the courage and bravery of the personnel will play in the background.
इस बार NDRF को पहली बार मौका मिला है इतने बड़े लेवल पे अपनी जो हम लोगों को किस प्रकार से लोगों की जान बचाते हैं, हमारे रेस्क्यूअर किस प्रकार से अपनी जान जोखिम में डाल के लोगों की जान बचाते हैं, तो और किस प्रकार की आपदाओं से हम निपटते हैं. जैसे कि चाहे फ्लड को लेके बात करें तो हमारी जो बोट है उसमें दिखाया गया कि किस प्रकार हमारे डीप डाइवर्स हमारे रेस्क्यूअर्स लोगों की जान अगर ऐसी बाढ़ आती है जिसमें लोग अपने आप को सक्षम नहीं समझते हैं तो वहाँ पहुँच के हम भयंकर बाढ़ से निपटते हुए लोगों की जान बचाते हैं.
The Finance Ministry will showcase the achievements of the financial inclusion drive through a tableau. India's financial inclusion efforts have won recognition from the World Bank, as their data indicated that 55% of new bank accounts opened are from India. The Defence Ministry had received 32 tableau proposals from states and union territories and 24 from central ministries and departments. However, some were rejected after examination by an expert committee. The proposals are evaluated by the expert committee comprising eminent persons in the fields of art, culture, painting, sculpture, music, architecture and choreography, among others. The committee examines the proposals on the basis of theme, concept, design and its visual impact before making its recommendations.
Every year, millions of viewers watch the Republic Day event, and the only public broadcaster responsible for streaming it is the Prasar Bharati. Hours of live coverage, thousands of soldiers, children and artists. The Prasar Bharati has an arduous task at hand, but does it seamlessly and with dexterity?
As India celebrates its 71st Republic Day, most of us will be glued to our TV sets to watch the brilliant parade on Delhi's Rajpath. Just like every year, this year also, the Republic Day parade will be broadcast live on Doordarshan, India's national broadcaster. Elaborate arrangements have been made to ensure that the live coverage of the historic Republic Day celebrations from India Gate and Rajpath on 26 January 2020 and the beating retreat ceremony from Vijay Chowk on 29 January are of the highest standards. In a first, as Prime Minister Narendra Modi will pay tribute to martyrs at the newly built National War Memorial on the Republic Day, Doordarshan has made special arrangements for the broadcast.
इस बार 50 से भी ज़्यादा कैमरा एंगल से प्रोड्यूस होगा लाइव कवरेज. ये एक बहुत ही यूनिक इनिशिएटिव है. प्रसार भारती का गूगल इंडिया के साथ एक कोलैबोरेशन है जिसके तहत जो भी जहाँ भी हो दुनिया में वो अगर गूगल के सर्च पेज पे जाकर रिपब्लिक डे के लिए सर्च करेंगे तो उनको दूरदर्शन का लाइव स्ट्रीम दिखेगा, और ये जो लाइव स्ट्रीम है ये दूरदर्शन के यूट्यूब चैनल पे भी दिखेगा, और साइन लैंग्वेज के साथ ये डीडी न्यूज़ के यूट्यूब स्ट्रीम पे दिखेगा। और इस बार हमने 3 नए भाषाओं में भी कमेंट्री को स्टार्ट किया है, तो आप डीडी पुदिगाई पे आप तमिल में देख सकते हैं, डीडी सह्याद्री पर मराठी में, और डीडी बांग्ला पर बंगाली में। तो ये 3 अलग अलग भाषाओं में भी आप देख सकते हैं। और सबसे जो इनोवेटिव है इस बार वो न्यूज़ ऑन एयर हमारा जो मोबाइल ऐप है एंड्रॉयड और आईफोन ओएस पे, इस पे अगर जाएंगे तो आप अपना कैमरा एंगल चूज़ कर सकते हैं। तो या तो आप मेन जो स्ट्रीम है वो देख सकते हैं, मेन प्रोडक्शन वाला, इसके अलावा आप 360 डिग्री कैमरा को भी चूज़ कर सकते हैं, आप हमारा जो पैनोरामिक फिश आई कैमरा है उसको भी चूज़ कर सकते हैं। तो 3 अलग एंगल से आप रिपब्लिक डे परेड को देख पाएंगे ऐप के द्वारा। तो मैं चाहूँगा कि सभी लोग न्यूज़ ऑन एयर ऐप को डाउनलोड करें और उसका लेटेस्ट वर्जन डालें अपने फ़ोन के माध्यम से, ताकि जो टीवी के सामने नहीं हो वो दुनिया में जहाँ भी हो न्यूज़ ऑन एयर मोबाइल ऐप से आप देख पाएंगे।
This colorful spectacle has always been a viewer's delight and is being produced in high definition format, which ensures that viewers get sharper and better picture and sound quality. Doordarshan will have no less than 52 high definition latest state of art cameras in strategic positions and has laid 30 km of optical fiber network to cover the entire mega spectacle. Doordarshan personnel have been working for months with diverse agencies, from technical to camera, from programming to commentary. All have been working in tandem for installation, testing, commissioning, rehearsals, and finally to ensure uninterrupted live telecast of the elaborate coverage of the Republic Day.
इन्हीं चीजों को लेकर के जब हम तैयारी शुरू करते हैं तो हम चाहते हैं कि दर्शक इस परेड को पूरी भव्यता से देखें, और इसके बहुत सारे पहलू हैं, जैसे कि वेशभूषा, पोशाक, जो यहाँ झांकियाँ निकलती हैं अगर आप देखेंगे तो उस झांकियों में पूरे देश की झलक होती है, पूरे देश की संस्कृति की, उनके म्यूज़िक की, कल्चर की, जो बच्चे आते हैं उनके पहनावे, पोशाक, कॉस्ट्यूम्स, तो उसको उस भव्यता में दिखाना ये हमारे लिए बड़ा चैलेंज होता है। और समय की भी सीमा होती है, एक्टिविटी बहुत ज़्यादा होती है, तो भी हम चाहते हैं कि हर फॉर्मेशंस को हम उसको टिप टू टो जो है पूरा दिखाएं। परेड जो चलती है, एक सिंक्रोनाइज्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ सोल्जर्स जो होता है वो अपने आप में एक बड़ा ही आनंददायी होता है। तो जैसा हम आँखों से देखते हैं वहाँ पे, हम चाहते हैं कि वैसा ही हम दर्शकों को दिखा पाएँ, बल्कि उससे बेहतर दिखा पाएँ। क्योंकि अगर आप राजपथ पर हैं तो आप 2 आँखों से देख रहे हैं, लेकिन अगर आप दूरदर्शन पर हैं तो आप 52 आँखों से देख रहे हैं। हमने 52 कैमरों का सेटअप लगाया हुआ है।
India will celebrate 71st Republic Day with a grand military parade and exhibition of its history, cultural diversity and strategic weaponry at the Rajpath, the city's centerpiece boulevard. In the presence of thousands of spectators, including foreign dignitaries and countries top political and military brass. The grand parade will start from Raisena Hills in the neighborhood of the majestic Rashtrapati Bhavan and will pass through the Rajpath. Every year, the parade has breathtaking displays. The formation of combat helicopters, the showcasing of tanks and rocket launchers, various different marching bands, colorful tableau of the different states. Each year, this festival is celebrated with great fervor and enthusiasm. The celebrations at the Rajpath that enthrall the nation with majestic skills are a result of hard work and determination of